I was very fortunate when I came to the Middlesex Hospital Medical School, because there was a technician already there, Amata Hornbruch, and she became my hands for the next 20 or so years. And we're still very, very good friends. And because I'm not good at experiments, and we did, she did all the experiments, and we published a lot of papers together. I was also blessed with a number of very good colleagues. One of my PhD students was Dennis Summerbell, who actually married Amata Hornbruch and who died just a few years ago. He was a very good PhD student. There was Julian Lewis, who was a physicist who wanted to get into developmental biology, and whom I hired over the telephone from Moscow without even seeing him. And then Cheryll Tickle came as a postdoc, and we worked extremely happily together, and we put forward a series of models which could explain patterning and positional information in the developing limb bud. Based on some experiments by a man called John Saunders, we came up with the idea that for the anterior posterior, this is anterior, this is posterior of the limb, there was a signaling region in this part of the limb. And if you grafted that to the anterior part of your thing, then you'd get a mirror image limb. And in fact, we analyzed this in some detail. And then we came up with another model in which how the cells knew their position. This gave a signal, a graded signal. And that graded signal told at a high concentration you'd make this digit, and at the low concentration, this one. So this was gradients. It was a gradient model. For this axis going along this way, we came up with a model which is a bit more complicated, in which the cells in the developing limb measured how long they remained near the tip. It was based on time.